Hey folks, Dagan here from PMTVUK, and today I have the pleasure of sharing with you 13, I think 13, probably a little bit more actually, 13 essential items us guitar players need to take to gigs with us. Now this is the case obviously for the beginners out there that are about to do their first gig, step on stage for the first time, you don't know what to bring. Like, obviously guitars, amplifiers and pedals and stuff, these are things that you forget. These are things that personally I have written down in a checklist on my phone so I don't forget, because even if you're an established guitar player, you will forget things. I forget things all the time, hence the list. So instead of you having to write down these lists, here's me here to tell you. So you can write them down yourself. You haven't got to think of them all by yourself. Or experience them all by yourself, I should say. You haven't got to go through the hardship of forgetting something, then having to remind yourself later on. And as always, if you want to expand on anything that I talk about in this video or add anything, please comment down below. And everything that I talk about will be linked in the description box down below as well. So you can check it out at pmtonline.co.uk. That's enough rambling. Let's get straight into it. Now the first one is quite obvious. It is some spare strings. I'm going to talk about spare guitars and amplifiers and stuff in a second, but spare strings. Nothing worse than having a string snap on stage. It is a bit of a pain halfway through a song if a string snaps and you haven't got a backup guitar to get off the stage and restring it while the drummer's trying to make jokes in the microphone, but it's better than not having a spare string at all. So every guitar player out there needs to have a spare set of strings in their gig bag, in their pedalboard bag, or whatever. Like, say, if that's acoustic guitar player as well, if acoustic guitar players want to watch this. Even if you like use Elixirs or Daddario XTs and XSs, the expensive strings, and you don't necessarily want to buy two sets of expensive strings, buy a cheap set as well, just in case. This whole video is going to be leaning very heavily on backups, so if something goes wrong, you're not left in the cold on stage. Next up to go along with that, Toolkit. An assortment of tools, or even just like one of these multi-tools that Dunlop do. So, if anything were to go wrong and snap a string, it's a lot quicker with the string winder. If the guitar pickup falls into the body or something happens, have a screwdriver, have a set of pliers, have string stretchers or clips or whatever, pliers, whatever you need. Just a little tiny toolkit. It hasn't got to be fancy, it hasn't even got to be guitar brand and stuff. Just get yourself to B&Q, buy a little cheap toolkit with even a screwdriver and a set of Allen keys, it will make a world of difference. And say, if someone isn't as prepared as you, your other guitar player or bass player, let's say, and you've got all the goodies to fix it, he'll thank you. He might buy you a pint. So yeah, have a little toolkit or a multi-tool with you at all times, just to save the day, just in case. Speaking of saving the day, there's one piece of kit that every musician, not only guitar player, needs in their arsenal at all times, just in case, because it saves the day again and again. It is, of course, gaffer tape. It cleans up cables on stage. If your strap falls off, just put a little bit of gaffer tape on, like a pop punk band from the 90s, and your strap isn't going anywhere. This thing has saved my ass so many times, it's unbelievable. Even in this room doing videos, if a camera tripod thing breaks, gaffer tape. Something happens to a guitar, gaffer tape. My laptop stopped working, wrap it in gaffer tape. It's just kind of, everyone needs some gaffer tape, and good quality gaffer tape. It is worth spending that little bit, I couldn't even talk about gaffer tape, but good quality gaffer tape is worth spending that little bit more, and always get a couple. Get one black one, so no one can see it, and get a glow-in-the-dark one, like a neon green one, so everyone can see it. Just for the times where it's something quite important, like I've got glow-in-the-dark pedalboard tape on my pedalboard, so in the dark I know where my volume pedal is and all that kind of jazz, but get regular dark stuff and neon yellow or green stuff, because you never know when you'll need it, and I guarantee at some point you will need it. I'm going to leave this tape here for this video just to remind me of the importance of gaffer tape so you can look at it as well and go, I need to buy some more gaffer tape. Anyways, next up is something just as important, if not more important than gaffer tape, and that's a tuner. Now, I know a lot of people do have tuners and it's like, why are you saying a tuner? Everyone stays in tune. The amount of guitar players I know out there that don't have a tuner because they can tune with their ear, and that's mint. Go for it. Have all the fun in the world with that. It's fine when you're in a practice room or in your own bedroom or wherever, studio. When you're on stage and it's loud, or even if you buy yourself acoustic artist, tuning up on stage and someone at the front's going, play some Britney Spears, mate! You can't tune up. So a little clip-on tuner is ideal. They don't cost an arm and a leg. Again, pictures right here of awesome tuners and they're all linked in the description box down below. And get yourself an awesome little clip-on tuner, or ideally a pedal tuner, if you have got a pedal board, because it kills the signal, which is awfully handy. So not only can you tune, I've got my little TU2 down here on the floor, which I've had since I was 15. It still works. The TU3's there now. That's even better. But the TU2, it's old. It still works. It kills the signal and it keeps everything in tune. So you need to bring a tuner to your gigs. No matter how cool you think you are, by tuning by ear, get yourself a tuner, just in case. Now, I've been very guilty of this next one, of not, well, not bringing this next one. It's very important. Extension cables with a knot in, evidently. The amount of times I've been at a gig, and I've got my pedal board plugged in, and my amp, and I've got my little IEC cable, I'm like, oh, where do I plug it in? To the sound guy, have you got any extensions? And they roll their eyes. They've always got extensions because it's part of their job, and they know everyone forgets, but it makes your life so much easier. Just bring a couple of extension cables. Don't cost a lot of money. It puts your mind at ease to know that you've always got power. And yeah, remember extension cables in your kit because it just makes everything so much easier. Get them. You can even get the Dario ones that are black and red and cool and stuff. You haven't just got to buy these cheap B&Q ones. You actually get snazzy ones. So yeah, extension cable. Chatting about power and cables and stuff, that brings me on to the next one, and that is spare cables. Bring spare cables, because if you've got a crackly cable or you plug everything good to go and the cable isn't working, screwed. Just pack everything up, get yourself home. If you've got a spare cable, it'll save the day. It will absolutely save the day. Whether you use fancy cables, cheap cables, at some point something can happen to them. They can twist in the wrong way and they can either die or get awfully crackly, and your crowd don't want to hear that. So always bring spare guitar cables, the quarter inch cables. And with that, patch cables as well. Between your pedals, if something dies, replace the patch cable, and also power. If you run 9-volt power supplies and stuff, always have a backup just in case. I know that's really obvious, bring spare cables and stuff, and you might be like, oh, I always bring spare cables. A lot of people don't. I've been to many gigs and people haven't got cables. I always lend out my spare cables, luckily nothing happens to me, but bring spare cables yourselves. You know who you are, the guys that live on a whim, live on a knife edge and don't bring any spares to gigs. And one day, you'll get right in the swear word. Anyways, next up. Batteries. Batteries are very handy things to have. Even if your guitar doesn't run on batteries, you never know when you might need a battery. Obviously, EMGs, like metal guitars, Seymour Duncan Blackouts, Fishman Fluence. I've got one on the back of this for the Sustainiac. 9-volt batteries, the little square ones, as well as AA batteries. Pedals, if the power supply dies and you haven't got a spare battery, AA batteries for acoustic guitars and stuff. Or we'll just have a little pocket full of batteries, just in case. Again, you might be sitting watching this thinking, I've never once needed batteries. And I thought I never once needed batteries before I got all these kind of guitars and stuff with powers in and stuff. I wrote it down on my phone at some point, buy batteries in capitals, because someone needed batteries, I needed batteries, the band needed to get saved somehow, whether it was me or the singer or the whatever bass player with his preamp and his bass. Always carry batteries, just in case. Now, next up, we have an interesting one. Always bring stuff to gigs so people know who you are. Like, if you've got a big banner at the back of the stage, that's all well and good. If your name's on your bass drum, that's all well and good. Business cards is a very formal way of doing it. If you're in a function band or something, business cards with your email address on and all your links and stuff is a very handy way. Obviously, you can do that in regular bands as well. But merch, key rings, something, because people are listening to the music. Sometimes people don't open their eyes, man, and they want to know what they're listening to. So afterwards, they can come up and go, oh, that was awesome. What's your band called? And instead of you going, big light in the sky, they go, oh, that's great, I'll find you on Facebook. After a few more pints, they will forget. But if they have a business card, a key ring, a pin, something, that will make them remember. And yeah, just get something so when someone asks you that, you're not just kind of fumbling on their phone on Facebook or Instagram or something, so they know and they can actually keep it. Even if they put it in their pocket, they'll forget about it until the next day when they're hungover. They'll pull it out and be like, oh yeah, that band, I'm gonna check them out. Don't forget that. Now, next up, we have a very important one. That's guitar picks. So it's obvious. You bring guitar picks, who's going to forget guitar picks? You will forget guitar picks at one point and it will suck. Doing this job, as you can imagine, I have a plethora of guitar picks. My pockets are full of guitar picks as we speak. I've got guitar picks on the headstock. Live, I have them on the mic stand as well as on the headstock. The amount of gigs I've got there and I put new jeans on and I'm playing a fancy gig and I've got to wear suit pants or something and I have no picks on me at all. It's the worst feeling in the world, especially when, like, I use Jazz 3 XLs, quite a unique pick, and the singer uses really thick picks, and I have to borrow his picks. I'm just having a bit of an unpleasant time for the entire 2 hours on stage. So, buy your picks, buy more picks, buy even more picks, and hide them places. Put them in every jacket you own. Put them in every pocket of all the pants that you own. Hide them in your gig bag, hide them in your rucksack, hide them in your guitar gig bag. Everything you can, so in the eventuality that you get there and you check your pockets and you go, oh, I put loads in my pedalboard case, I put loads in my gig bag. Thank God, Dagan told me I'm not an absolute arse like Dagan and forgets his picks all the time. Buy lots of picks and hide them places. You'll be surprised, even established guitar players, if you haven't got a guitar tech looking after them, you will forget your picks and you feel like a right moron. We're gonna get a bit more intense with this last bunch of goodies, but next up we have a pedal board. Now, if you don't use pedals, you don't need a pedal board. But if you do use pedals, still to this day now, I see people rock up to gigs with a rucksack with their pedals in and their power supply and their cables, and they put them out the rucksack, place them on the floor, plug everything in, then once they're finished, they put everything back in their rucksack and all the cables get tangled. That's absolutely fine, but you haven't got to spend a lot of money on getting a good pedal board these days. Like these Toolkit ones are kind of like the pedal train ones, but a lot cheaper. It comes in a handy little gig bag, loads of different sizes, super lightweight. It makes setting up and setting down, that's the term, so much easier. Pull it out, put it on the floor, it comes with Velcro and stuff, everything's just good to go, straight out the box. No more pulling out your backpack and having to set everything up every single time you go to a rehearsal or a gig. Everything's just there and then. So if you can, try and invest in a pedal board just to make your life a bit easier. Next up, you have something that doesn't really change the world, but it is cool to have, and that is a guitar stand. It's like when you're not playing your guitar on stage, whether someone, like another band's on stage, or like if you've got a few guitars, and you change your guitars during the set, a guitar stand, again, doesn't cost a lot of money, and there's a few different variants out there. Most popular being like these A-frame ones from Toolkit. Plonk it down like that. Back of the stage. Not loads of coin. Boom. It looks pro. Super pro. That's awesome. Just have that at the back of the stage. When you go on, grab your guitar off the stand, put it back down. You haven't got to keep it in this gig bag or keep it in a case off the stage. It's just there, ready to go. There are other ones available as well. Like this is popular, but I'll show you the one that I use. It's this Hercules one. Again, I'll link it in the description box down below. I think I actually picked up the acoustic guitar one, but I use the electric version. Comes with a little bag, which is still in here. It folds right down, and that sits in my gig bag or my pedalboard bag or whatever. And when you come to playing on stage, just unfold it from itself. How does he do this again? There we go, we've got a full-on guitar stand for stage use. Super portable, super easy, and it just makes you feel a little bit more pro on stage and everything's set up good to go. I feel naked without a guitar, so I'm gonna put this back on to talk about the second to last one, which is protecting yourself from noises, from sounds. It's ear protection, of course it's ear protection. You only get one set of ears. You can regrow your arms and fingers back, but you can't regrow your ears. Alpine do great in-ear protection earplugs with different levels of noise cancellation. So you can a lot of earplugs when you buy them, that's it. You're kind of stuck. And if you are like me and you like a lively stage, but don't want to affect your hearing, I want a little bit of noise deadening. Not loads. And there's some different variants in some of the Alpines, not all of them. Alpine? Alpine. Alpine is the F1 team, so I'm going to say Alpine. There are different variants available, obviously, but ear protection, I didn't use it for years, and I'm scared to say that it's starting to affect my hearing a little bit because I like a loud stage. So as soon as you can start gigging, please start gigging with ear protection, because again, you only get one set of lugs, don't you? And last but certainly not least, we have a big one, which a lot of people probably won't have because it's the most expensive little extra to bring to a gig, and that's a spare guitar and a spare amp. You can have the strings, like I said at the start, replace the strings, but if something happens to the electronics on your guitar or something, kind of screwed. I always bring two guitars to gigs. I rarely use two guitars. I think only one occasion in all the 485 years I've been playing guitar, I've had to use a backup, but it's there if I need it. And I know the one time I don't bring it, something bad will happen. And again, you haven't got to have a super fancy backup guitar if you're a bit strapped for cash. You can get great guitars for not a lot of money, like these antiquity guitars from PMT, like 100, 200 quid. Those kind of things, just to have, just in case. Just in case. It's the same with amplifiers and multi-effects boards and helixes and Kempers and head rushers and stuff. If your amp breaks or your pedal board breaks, that's kind of you screwed. But there are some little fail safes, let's say, which are awesome in themselves and also great for backups. Using me as an example again, I either use this Blackstar St. James Live or the Blackstar Department 10 amp 2 pedal board thing. And that's great. If they die though, this is always in my pedalboard case. This is a Blackstar Department 10 dual drive. There's a number of different pedals out there which do this, but this literally has a guitar in, effects loop, and a line out with a cab rig on it. So this has a cabinet built in and clean sounds, distorted sounds, all that kind of stuff as my little backup. You can use this if you want. There's so many different options out there, like small little backup guitar amp and box pedals and stuff. Have a backup. You haven't got to buy another Marshall stack, but always try. If you can and you can afford it, get a backup for your amplifier, just in case. And there we have it. Those are the little goodies that I think every guitar player should take to gigs, along with their regular guitar, pedal board, and amplifiers and all the rest. just in case. Write them all down in your phone, never forget them, and always take them to a gig, because the one time you forget, you will need them. That's how the world works. If you want to expand on anything, like I said, please comment down below and add your own little fun little tidbit of information on what guitar players should bring to gigs. If you like this video, give it an old thumbs up and subscribe to PMTVUK here on YouTube. We are playing music today on all social media platforms. I've been Dagan, and I'll see you next time.